tech training. There's no engineering class that teaches you how to restore or preserve a spacecraft. Now NASA, when they were working on their spacecraft and developing the craft and the spacesuits, these were intended for one-time flight, one-time use only. NASA didn't view them as a historic document. NASA didn't view them as things that would end up in museums. They didn't think about putting something together that would be able to be preserved and whether being on display or in storage for a long period of time. So you think about a spacecraft and a spacesuit. They're comprised of many dissimilar types of materials. When dissimilar materials are in the same environment, they have adverse reactions. That adverse reaction is the deterioration or corrosion process. So the cosmosphere began to work out techniques that would at least halt that deterioration or remove that deterioration. In some cases, we even are able to prevent it. So in the early 80s, we began to develop these techniques and began to restore spacecraft and spacesuits. Well, that caught the attention of the Smithsonian and NASA. And to this day, any American flown spacecraft that needs restoration by the Smithsonian has to come here to Hutchinson first. So the Smithsonian, with the exception of one spacecraft, and I'll get to that in a little bit, owns all of the American flown spacecraft. From Mercury all the way up to Shuttle, the Smithsonian owns them. They just lend them to other entities throughout the United States. But even though they have their own restoration division, which is now out at the Halsey Center at Dulles Airport, they still don't do their own artifact restoration.